every human creature is a profound secret to every other.
Until that secret is given to another, and then perhaps two human creatures may know each other.
Okay, so you came on board with this film as a director first, but then to actually play the role of Charles Dickens, I understand you had to persuade yourself. I'm fascinated about how that process works. How do you persuade yourself? Because in my mind, it's like this schizophrenic one-man show of you talking to yourself.
I mean, I directed myself in a film before, Coriolanus, and it was great, but it was tough, you know, and I came off of that thinking I'd like to direct a film, not be in it. And because I had directed and acted before, I sort of knew back in my head I could do it.
Yes, I can.
In the end, there's a bit of you as an actor that, especially as the people behind it wanted me to entertain the idea of playing Dickens.
I know, Abby, the writer, loves to talk about how she always knew you were going to play the role in the end.
Maybe some people did, and maybe I had to go through this sort of self-deluding process. Maybe I always sort of knew at some level.
And then music. No, not yet, Budge. I'm just marking through the cues. So we kiss, then...
Leap up into it with a mighty bound. And the ship was gone.
So, what was it about it? What is it about Dickens that makes him such an enticing character for you to play as an actor?
He's full of contradictions. I mean, I love characters that have sort of high-definition contradictions. I mean, he's socially very gregarious, generous, very vital, highly energized, sort of open-spirited sort of man. Socially, if he walked into a room, he would be managing the room and entertaining and being controlling, too. But I think there was a sort of joie de vivre about Dickens.
She is the mother of your children. How could you be so cruel to her?
And for that, I shall always be grateful. But I do not love her.
We meet Dickens here, who's been with his wife for 20-odd years and is now impatient. You know, and he's at that stage in a marriage where I think the initial flame of passion has gone.
We don't want to call it a midlife crisis, but
we can call it. Happy to call it a midlife crisis.
Dickens' midlife crisis would have been the slightly less poetic title for the film.
Yeah.
It's actually a very big week for you in terms of the Australian cinema scene because you've got two films out at the moment. You've got this film and you've got The Grand Budapest Hotel.
What happened?
What happened, my dear Zero, is I beat the living shit out of a snivelling little runt called Pinky Bandinsky.
In terms of you working with other directors, a director like Wes Anderson...
He's actually become a dear friend.
What are the best lessons you learned from working with different directors, particularly Wes?
Wes's preparation is astounding. I mean, I like to think I was well prepared, but I mean, Wes just...
You can't arrest him simply because he's a bloody immigrant.
Take your hands off my lobby boy!
Well, first of all, Wes, in this case, he storyboarded every shot. Some of these storyboards were even simply animated and edited, and he had recorded all the voices, so he had a very detailed plan of every scene.
Do you get much room to improvise in that?
No, he's written it very precisely. He's very fastidious about how it's going to come together in every level. That's who it is. And I think you don't take that job on without sort of being aware of that.
And I'll say action. And then you can sort of bang, 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 bang.
But there is room for manoeuvre because he does lots and lots of takes. And I think he loves the actors to find different nuances and emphasis within the sort of confines of the text.
I love you.
I love you. She was dynamite in the sack, by the way.
She was 84.
I've had older.
Having directed two films now, if you could go back and talk to yourself before you directed your first film, Coriolanus, what's the best piece of advice you'd give yourself?
Well, probably to do a bit more of the Wes Anderson. So you've got your very well-prepared plan, but you're also flexible enough to say for this scene, as you and me talking, I might shoot quite a conventional front-on. You don't have to change your. You look
I feel
very natural.
Like I'm being directed.
You suddenly changed. Stiff.
I'll go back.
You're all natural.
I'm a terrible actor.
I might say, why don't you get a little side angle on you? I like the idea that I can go, okay, that's the plan. Let's shoot the plan. If in shooting it we go, okay, we'll swap that shot for that, or we've got half an hour. Why don't we just pick up that? And then, you know, that's just a useful thing to have.
All right. Thank you so much for talking to us. I appreciate it.
Okay.